Hi again, Jeremy Chapman here, and I've got another Windows 11 tip that you have to try right now. It's for voice dictation. I'm going to show you how to do that in the next few minutes, so let's go. Okay, so a common problem that we have is a lot of times we have a great set of thoughts that we can verbally articulate, but we can't quite type them down. Maybe we just don't want to be typing them down, and we want to be able to have something kind of convert our speech into text. Well, Windows has had a great capability now by hitting the Windows key plus H for a while now, but now with Windows 11, it's actually added a punctuation feature for it, and it's super accurate. And one of the great things that you can do is actually create captions as well for videos that you've recorded, because it's always the best thing to have captions in place for anyone who needs to use the captions. It's also great if you're watching a video in silent mode, so you can see the captions that they're accurate. And the captions also will help in terms of reaching an international audience, because as you can imagine, if the native language of the video's captions are accurate, then any of the auto-translated versions of those will be more accurate as well. So I'm going to show you how to do that right now, just using Notepad along with the Windows plus H key. Okay, so you can see that I've got Notepad open here. I've hit already Windows key plus H to bring up this little guy here, the voice typing service. And so in settings, if I open that, you'll see that auto punctuation has been enabled. This is something that's brand new and it's super helpful. If you've ever done auto captioning, for example, on YouTube or a lot of other services, a lot of things that they don't do are capitalize, for example, the word I or I'm, or other things, I'll, you know, those types of words will have a lowercase I. There aren't any punctuation marks, periods, capital letters. Also, if you speak out product names, proper nouns, those types of things, those aren't always captured correctly. So I'm going to start recording so you can see how well it does the transcription of my voice. And you can see that it added punctuation to the end of the sentence. And also you'll see words like I, those are capitalized. So pretty cool. I'll go ahead and stop the recording. All right. Okay, so let's put this to the test. I'm actually going to record now something playing out of my phone speaker. A YouTube short that I recently recorded about how to record your screen from the Stream app inside of Office 365 from the browser without installing any local apps. We're going to see just how well it can transcribe what's there, even with all the underlying music and other things and me speaking as fast as I do. And to do that, I've got to do a couple things to set this up. So I'm going to go ahead and get my recording ready.
And now when I hit the record button, okay, so I'll record the entire screen and I'll hit share. Now that starts the countdown, and once that's started, you want to leave this browser tab open.
So as you saw, it really did a great job in terms of transcribing speech to text. So now all you would need to do with these caption files then in something like YouTube is upload a text file without timing. It will do all the rest in terms of matching up all the timing with the words. So hopefully this was a great tip for you, one creator to another, for getting captions into your videos, something that everybody should be doing. So if you like this tip, please give me a like. Otherwise, subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And as always, thank you so much for watching.